This video is brought to you by the Zimbabwe Travel Guide. More info on that later.
Visiting a country can change your perspective about that country. Before I visited Zimbabwe, I did some search on the internet and you are not going to believe some of the things that I saw.
The UN's World Food Programme says more than 8 million Zimbabweans will not have enough food by December.
Also, there's still a large number of people who are dealing with chronic illness.
There is really no country out there that is perfect, but at the end of the day, you really do need to visit to see the reality for yourself. And also, on the flip side, we Africans do need to start telling these stories ourselves.
Look guys, I went to shoot some real estate to kind of like give me an insider perspective of where Zimbabweans live in. I'm telling you, we're talking about Berlin type of infrastructure. You see how powerful the media can be. I am not oblivious of the fact that this country has, you know, sanctions and leadership issues. This video is just solely about selling the Zimbabwean destination to you. And I hope at the end of this video, you would be lured to visit Zimbabwe for yourself. Let's go.
I will appreciate it if you give this video a like and please subscribe to the channel. The people of Zimbabwe are naturally very friendly. I don't know what exactly is it that makes them so. They smile more and it's cultural when you go into their homes, they'll offer you something to eat. I've put on some extra weight in just a few weeks. I felt so welcome and loved, like I belong here. So, getting the visa is pretty easy. They've got e-visa, so you can download the travel guide to get more information about how you can apply and get the visas, and also the cheapest airline you can use as well. So you just touch down Harare, you need a place to stay. If you watch my videos, you know I would prefer staying in apartments against hotels to save costs. So, during my stay in Harare, I lived in a very nice two-bedroom duplex in Griston Park Estate. It's among the top most prestigious neighborhoods in Zimbabwe.
I make sure I show you guys every single where I stay when I'm visiting the country. So I got a very nice Airbnb. It's a two-bedroom Airbnb right here in Griston Park. Very nice apartment. This is what the living room and the kitchen looks like. It's an open kitchen. And this is the main room right here. This is where I sleep. It's ensuite. You have your wardrobe. A very nice bed. I have a lot of duvets. Wooden staircase. Climb up. Okay, this is the other option. It's a two bedroom as I told you. And this one sounds like the penthouse because it has a very nice view. So let me show you some of the things you can do outside. Now you have a trampoline here. So this is what the pool looks like. On this end, you have a bar. You have a sit out area right here. Follow me all the way to the back. You have a basketball and a tennis court. Another trampoline.
You can go ahead and download the travel guide. You'll see other apartment options you got while in Harare. Zimbabwe is a landlocked country located in the south of Africa between the Zambezi and the Limpopo Rivers. The country is bordered by South Africa, Botswana, Zambia, and Mozambique. The capital and the largest city is Harare and is the most populated city, home to 3 million people. The people of Zimbabwe, they are big on conservation. Planting trees and nurturing gardens is a thing right here. Even in the most busiest streets, you're going to find trees and gardens. I didn't spend so much time in Harare, so if you're a tourist visiting Zimbabwe, there's little or nothing you can do right here in Harare. So I would highly suggest you spend just a few days here, settle in, and then head to Victoria Falls as your first stop.
Tinokuchingamidzai muZimbabwe, muve nenguva yakanaka muZimbabwe.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Zimbabwe.
There are several ways you can travel to Vic Falls. Driving is obviously the longest, about 10-11 hours thereabout, but gives you the ability to make multiple stops and admire the scenery. But flying is just about an hour. I opted in for that because I had just a few weeks to spend. Shout out to FastJet for the complimentary tickets to Vic Falls.
So we're actually on our runway now, about to take off. The plane is packed up, it's full. It's the Embraer 145, and we heard like they have two flights leaving for Big Falls every day. It's a 1 hour flight. Let's see how it goes.
So FastJet is a major operating airline in Zimbabwe. You can fly to Bulawayo, Vic Falls, Joburg, Botswana, and Nail Spirit. The customer service is great. And just a little joke here, a friend was going to pick us from the airport and asked why we arrived 5 minutes earlier than scheduled. I told him, it's FastJet, baby. Go ahead and check out their website at fastjet.com.
Thank you. Bye.
Hi, thank you. Bye-bye.
Welcome to Victoria Falls, my man.
Arriving Vic Falls, the temperature here is a bit higher compared to that of Harare, so you're going to have to keep your jacket away. Victoria Falls City is a resort town that lies on the southern bank of the Zambezi River at the eastern end of the almighty Victoria Falls. This small town with 35,000 people living in it was formed largely due to the Victoria Falls. Vic Falls town is filled with hotels, resorts, and safari lodges, over 50 of them. Someone has to guide you on which is the best.
This video, of course, is brought to you by the Zimbabwe Travel Guide. It's a PDF I always create whenever I visit countries. I got to realize that it's so helpful in navigating tourists that want to visit a destination that I have visited. Because prior to coming here, I had no plans. I'm sorting out things myself, going on the internet to, you know, search and look for best places to visit, affordable accommodations, resorts and activities and all of those things. Now, this travel guide is sort of like your tour guide. It's going to show you the affordable apartment, affordable resort, you know, real estate as well, if you want to buy real estate as well. It's going to show you activities you can do, places you can visit. Basically, you don't need to do any search on the internet if you want to visit Zimbabwe. Because I have been to all these resorts myself, I've met all these owners of apartments, done all these activities, I have direct contact to the owners and they gave me good deals, and you're going to see them there for yourself, all right? So all you have to do is go to the description section, go download it and kind of like support the channel, because it's little things like this we used to afford, you know, traveling and making these beautiful videos for you guys. So let's proceed back to the video.
Now, before we go ahead and check out the falls, let me show you where I'm going to be staying. The first two nights I checked in Ilala, and it's one of the oldest resorts here and is the closest to the Victoria Falls. So it's so close that the terrace has views showing the sprays of the falls.
All right, guys, welcome to room number 7, which is the presidential suite, or you can call it a Strathen, which is named after the founder of the resort, right? Now, this room is actually very spectacular, very different from the other rooms. I'll just give you a highlight. It has a living room, it has a bigger balcony outside, it has a bathtub, it has its own private room and can be expanded to having two rooms as well. The design here is really unique. It has a guest toilet and a kitchenette, like some people would like to call it, all right?
If you want that resort that has the African decor, very close to town, but still has that getaway vibes, then this is it.
So let me know if you like it, and of always, if you want to book this, you can look at the description section of this video, or you can go ahead and download the Zimbabwe Travel Guide.
I also stayed at their sister hotel, Palm River. It opened in December 2021. It's still very new, and the architecture, the room style, the decor is very different from the everyday hotel you're going to find in Vic Falls.
Stephen, welcome. This
Thank
is
you.
Where you're going to be staying. This is our villa at the Palm River Hotel. So come with me.
Okay.
Right, Mr. Steve, welcome to the villa. This is our kitchen and this is our lounge. This is a private living. We're gonna be offering private services for you, one of the main bedrooms. So if you need to occupy this room, it's all up to you.
This is, I like the whole white theme.
Yes.
It looks very neat and classic, huh? All right, the balcony and the infinity edge pool.
Yes, so the villa has got its own private infinity pool. This is the other bedroom. All right.
Oh, so, okay. This one has a twin bed.
Yes, it has a twin bed. It's one of the like our deluxe standard rooms. Mm-hmm. They come exactly like this one.
So what I really do love about the hotel is the proximity to the Zambezi. All the rooms have views of the Zambezi, and as a side activity, you can participate in the sunset boat cruises and dinner at the Zambezi. Matetsi was a different experience entirely.
So it's really unique because it's sitting on 55,000 hectares of land space. It's really big, it's really gigantic, and it's in a national park. That should tell you that there are so many activities you can do other than just staying in their luxury accommodations. It's just directly opposite the Zambezi, so your views and the air here is really untouched. All right, so this is the lounge area. You know, you can just sit down here, have fun. And then you have the private dining setup over there. And then on the far end, you have the kitchen. So your chef can come in and prepare special meals for you if you want. So this is what the main suite comes here. It's really unique from the rest because it's bigger, the bathrooms are bigger, and you have an even better view on here. Three ways you can have your bath. You can use the bathtub, you can use the indoor shower, and the outdoor shower.
I stayed here for two nights, and trust me when I say it was the best.
For me, I really do like it because it gives me that boutique hotel type of feeling, because there's just very limited rooms on here. You have 19 rooms and I think two villas. So when you get here, everything is personalized, from your water bottle, you know, your names are everywhere, and it makes them treat you like a king.
Each of the suite comes with its own private pool and a view of the Zambezi. While staying at Matetsi, you can go on a morning or evening game drive, and I was also told you can also go on a sunset boat cruise as well. I also did a couple of nights in Chundu Island. It's about 22 kilometers away from Victoria Falls. Getting here, you're going to need to drive in for about an hour and a half through the Zambezi National Park. You might get lucky and spot some animals on your way, like we spotted some giraffes and water bugs on our way. Chundu Island is possibly one of the most prettiest islands in this section of the Upper Zambezi River, being about 1 kilometer in length with beautiful white soft sandy beach on the upstream end of the island. Chundu Island has 8 East African style tents lined across the edge of the island, and the interior speaks for itself. It's a perfect place for getaway. Look, the internet doesn't really work here. You have to go to the reception to get data, because this place is a safari lodge. It was built to get away from it all.
It's a nice day. We're going out on a cruise, and we're looking at birds, looking at the scenery, the trees,
crocs,
animals,
hippos,
yes.
We had a 1 hour sunset cruise, and believe me when I say it was epic. Not only did we see unique birds, we saw crocs, hippos, and some other tourists enjoying the sunset as well. And while on this, we were served with some snacks, you know, champagnes. I can tell you it was really worth it. With every hotel and resort came with a different experience. So I don't make this video so long. In an upcoming episode, I'm going to probably count down the top 10 resorts in Zimbabwe just to give you more insight. So stay tuned, stay subscribed to the channel, or you can go ahead and download the travel guide.
So we're actually at the falls, one of the top activities you can do right here in Victoria Falls. I mean, I've seen a lot of videos and pictures about the falls.
It's about 30 bucks for international and 7 bucks for locals.
Okay, so we're going to start that way, where we just see the Zambezi before it plunges into the Batoka Gorge. So this guy, he was a travel blogger in the 19th century, and he was the first person, the first foreigner to see the falls. And he's the one who actually spoke to the rest of the world about the falls and started marketing the falls. So we're at viewing point number 3. This is the Mosiwaya Tunya. The Zambezi travels from the northern parts of Zambia through Angola. Then it comes through the Quadra Point, the only place in the world where 4 countries meet: Zimbabwe, Zambia, Botswana, and Namibia. Passes through there, back into Zimbabwe, while Zambia is on the other side, all the way through to Mozambique. It travels about 2,700 kilometers from source to the Indian Ocean. So where we are here in the Big Falls, in the Mosiwaya Tunya, world famous, it's right in between the source and the mouth, somewhere in the middle, about 1,300 kilometers.
The falls is one of the world's largest falling sheets of water. It's one of the 7 natural wonders of the world and has quickly become a regional center for adventure.
All right, guys, so we just saw the viewing points right here at the falls, but I tell you, you've only seen just a bit of how beautiful this place looks. Look, there is no way to view the falls than from being on top.
After a very stressful day touring the Victoria Falls, I decided to go on an evening sunset cruise on the Bamba Tram.
So we're about to head for the sunset cruise, right?
Sure.
Have you been on it before?
No, because the last time I was here, there was COVID, but I know it's beautiful because I visited and I have an idea how it's happening.
Fingers crossed, as I don't know what I'm expecting to see.
While on this cruise, you're going to drive into a national park for some kilometers to spot wildlife while also admiring the sunset. It was a really nice experience. We also had dinner while watching the sunset. I had some random conversations with other tourists as well. But really, my highlights for that day was the boma. So we were actually called last minute to attend the boma dinner and drink show.
What happens at the boma?
There is traditional dancing, dinner and drum show.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of food inside there.
If you think I added an extra weight, this was where it actually happened. The food never runs out. Eat as your tummy can carry.
I'll be at your service tonight together with Leona. And with me here is our welcome drink. It's an African brewed beer, 4% alcohol. It's called Chibuku.
2% knocks me out, right? And this is 4% now. Yes. It's going to do wonders
for me. Going to pour in your cups, then you do have it.
What is this? Why does it taste that way?
It's just sour, yeah. That's how it is. Crocodile tail meat.
Hi.
Actually very confusing out here because there's just a lot of things to pick from. So it makes it really hard to find what you want to eat.
What?
We learned how to play drums and also listen to African a cappella. With over 50 related activities, you can never run out of what to do in Victoria Falls. Go ahead and download the Zimbabwe Travel Guide for more information on the activities you can do and how you can book them. My hunt for adventure took me to the Eastern Highlands. It's a mountainous area of spectacular natural beauty. Rolling hills, green forests, rock peaks, misty valleys, cascading waterfalls, and sparkling rivers. You have lakes and resorts spread around as well. This is a totally different side of Zimbabwe that most visitors don't know. The cool, damp temperature here, the lush green landscapes of the Eastern Highlands contrasts every other part of Zimbabwe. We first arrived at Mutare. It is the capital city and the third most populous city right here in the province of Manicaland and the third most populous city in Zimbabwe after Harare and Bulawayo. It's also the largest city in the Eastern Highlands.
I'm the guy you're supposed to look for when you think of someone in Mutare.
So what is so special about the city though?
No, so Mutare is the capital of Manicaland, which is the Eastern Highlands. This is our gateway to the Indian Ocean. So from 1890, until now, they've been building up the city. We also have the best water in Zimbabwe.
Why do you say you have the best water?
Because it comes from a spring. We're drinking spring water. So Fun fact, this water is not pumped all the way from Punga to Mutare. It's just gravity flowing.
Wow.
All the way until it gets to the tap.
So maybe I should move here now, so my skin can be as fresh as yours, huh?
While in the Eastern Highlands, I stayed at two beautiful resorts. The first was the Musangano Lodge. It's tucked away in the lower slopes of the three covered hillside of the Highlands. Well-equipped accommodation under thatched chalets and lodges for up to 32 guests. They've got chalets for two, self-catering lodges and a campground as well. The interior is very African-like and old school. You're going to expect this from a resort that was opened in 1996. But I love it here, if you'd ask me.
I love it here. The tourism is amazing.
Yeah. So tell us a little bit of the things people can do when they come here to Mutare.
Also, when people come here, if you enjoy nature, this is the best place. There's some serene areas to go into Vumba. Vumba means mist. So that's the place where the clouds form at ground level. So people can go there for a bright day. People can go there to chase waterfalls.
Yeah.
You're about 45 minutes away from the second highest waterfall in Africa.
We'll welcome you guys here to Mutarazi Waterfall.
Thank you.
This is the highest waterfall in Zim and second highest in Africa. We do have here at Mutarazi two activities, which are skywalk, these two bridges, 40 meter first one, by 90 meter the bottom one. We also do have the zip line or skyline, of which you use the first bridge as the connecting one. And then you take a 10 minute hike to the starting point, and then you slide on those 400 meter cables, of which it is also the highest zipline in the world on natural ground.
The second resort I stayed in was absolutely breathtaking. You'd be forgiven if you had thought Trotbeck Inn to be a Scottish highland rather than in the Nyanga Mountains of Zimbabwe, because I thought the same. Accommodation here comprises of 70 beautifully styled rooms with a number of options ranging from the superior to deluxe, and they have also got a regular room. All rooms offer ensuite bathrooms with a view of the lakes and the mountains at the back. Look guys, I planned on staying in Zimbabwe for just 2 weeks, and I had to extend my trips for another 2 weeks, which is not enough time to explore this destination. What you have seen is just a scratch surface of what you can experience if you visit for yourself. This is one of my most favorite trips I have taken. I'll be very happy to revisit this country again in the nearby future, but for the meantime, stay tuned for the other episode I'll be posting here on the channel about Zimbabwe. It will be truly worth your while. Support the channel by liking this video, and please do hit that subscribe button, and I'm going to see you in the next video.